Gracious in heaven, the Father, we just praise and thank you once again for another day and for another morning. We thank and praise you, Lord, even as we look to your word. I pray that you would look to us from heaven above. I pray you will speak through my mind and speak through my vocal cords and hide me, your unworthy servant, behind the cross. I pray in Jesus' precious name we ask, Lord. Amen. This morning I'm going to speak to you from the book of Joshua. Chapter 3 and verse 5. It is an important topic, and the topic is none other than sanctify yourself, especially in the light of the COVID-19 and the pandemic that we face in our nation in Sri Lanka. I believe this word is for each and every one of us, that we might take the time to sanctify ourselves and become what God wants you and me to become, that we might be a shining light in the midst of darkness that prevails in a nation such as ours at a time and a moment like this. So to begin, my subject this morning is about talking about sanctification or to sanctify yourself. So looking at your Bibles at Joshua chapter 3 and verse 5, it's all based on that one verse. If God must work a work in your life, the first thing that we must learn to do is to sanctify ourselves or to make ourselves holy. As Joshua puts it to his people whom he addresses, and he says to them, sanctify yourselves for tomorrow. The Lord will do wonders among you. Amen. If you want the Lord to do something tomorrow, the secret behind it is learning to sanctify yourselves. The Lord wants us to make our life a little of wonder, and tomorrow a different day than the day we stand on today. The reason why he cannot and is unable to do so is not because of God, but because of you and me. Because if you look at Joshua, looked upon these people to whom he was speaking as a nation, whose yesterdays were a long list of repeated failures. Because of their own rebellion and because of their own sin, which was repeated over and over again. You can see for yourself also in that crowd. The time had to come for him as he took over the leadership from Moses to tell the people, first sanctify yourselves and understand that it is your yesterday that has made you what you are today. Amen. However, he encouraged them by also saying, but your tomorrow can make you what God always intended you to be. God is fully aware of your yesterdays and of your failures. But our God is not the God who remembers our yesterdays. Amen. But he is much more focused on our tomorrow and the purpose that still remains for you to fulfill. If you look at the life story of Jesus, when on that cross he said, it is finished. Many of his own disciples misunderstood and thought it was all over for them as well. But look at the word of God and you will find that 3 mornings later, there was a new tomorrow. Even as Jesus had come out to the grave that had sealed him. So when he got up 3 mornings later, it was a new tomorrow for the disciples who were in hiding in their own little corner. So all that Joshua can say, that he says not only to them, but also to you. Don't give up your tomorrows by building moments on your past and failures. Many do. Don't have pity parties on what has happened, but gird up yourself and regard tomorrow as a new day and as a new beginning. For tomorrow, the Lord will do wonders for you. We have not come to the last miracle of Jesus as yet, for he is still doing miracles. So let us learn this day to put this message upon our lives, that we might become the living witness and the living testimony that Jesus would have us be for his glory in the midst of this pandemic. Remember, each and every one of you are a wonder, and God wants you to become that wonder for him and for him alone. Remember, tomorrow will be a new day, a new beginning for you and me. And he is certainly going to do miracles in your life and in my life and in the life of this nation. So let us all come before the throne of grace, trusting him and him alone to be our strength, to be our guide, to be our solace and comfort in the midst of great grief in this our land and nation. May God bless you, and may God enable you to apply this precious word of God on your life as it has been just a short word, and let that short word inspire you to become what Jesus would want you to be for him and for his glory. God bless you, and may he keep you as a living witness and as a living testimony, all to the abounding glory of his holy name. Father, I thank and praise you for this day, Father. I thank and praise you for your children. I thank you for your word. I pray that your word would speak to your children, and your word would find the lodging place and do the work that only you can do in the lives and hearts of your people, I pray. In Jesus' precious name we ask, Lord. Amen. Shalom, shalom, until we meet again.